Welcome to ISU Gen Chem Lab Tutorials. In this lesson, we will learn how to use a pH meter. A pH meter is used in the lab to measure the pH of a solution. The pH of a solution is a clue to the composition of and chemistry occurring in the solution. Our setup for doing this will include a pH meter, the glass of pH electrode attached to the pH meter, two or three buffer solutions to calibrate the pH meter. We will use buffer solutions with known pH values of 4, 7, and 10 for this demonstration. Deionize water to rinse the pH electrode between solutions, a large waste beaker to collect the rinsings, and finally a chem wipe tissue to dry the pH electrode. To begin, we'll first plug in the pH meter. When first turned on, the lower left corner of the display usually shows a couple of numbers, 4 and 7 in this case. These are the pH values of the buffers that were last used to calibrate this instrument. A calibration is no longer valid. We will first clear the buffers by pressing the Setup button and then the Enter button. The pH meter is now ready to be calibrated. First, remove the parafilm from the storage bottle. Hold the cap and rotate the bottle to unscrew it and place the bottle in a secure location where it is unlikely to be tipped over. Push the cap with its O-ring up a few inches on the electrode. To minimize contamination, we will always rinse and dry the electrode between solutions. With a large beaker placed underneath the pH electrode, thoroughly rinse the electrode with deionized water, then pat dry the electrode with a chem wipe tissue. Do not wipe dry. To calibrate, we will first use a buffer solution of pH of 4. Ensure the bottom of the electrode is fully immersed in the solution and swirl the solution. When the pH value in the display stabilizes, press the standardize button while continuing to swirl the pH 4 buffer solution. Remove the electrode from the pH 4 buffer solution. Rinse and dry it. Secondly, we will repeat the same process with the buffer solution as a pH of 7. When the pH value stabilizes, press the standardized button while continuing to swirl a pH 7 buffer solution. Remove the electrode from the pH 7 buffer solution. Rinse and dry it. Finally, we will repeat this process once more with a buffer solution as a pH of 10. When the pH value stabilizes, press the standardize button once more while continuing to swirl the pH 10 buffer solution. If everything is okay, the pH meter will display good electrode. Remove the electrode from the pH 10 buffer solution. Rinse and dry it. The pH meter is now ready to measure the pH of solutions. We will first measure the pH of a solution labeled unknown A. We'll immerse the pH electrode into the solution and swirl. The pH value when the display stabilizes is the pH of the solution, approximately 4.51. We remove the electrode from the unknown A solution, rinse, and dry it. We'll then measure the pH of solution labeled unknown B. Immerse the pH electrode into the solution and swirl. The pH value when the display stabilizes is the pH of the solution, approximately 4.49. We'll remove the electrode from the unknown B solution, rinse, and dry it. We have finally measured the pH of solution labeled unknown C. We'll immerse the pH electrode into the solution and swirl. pH value when the display stabilizes is the pH of this solution, approximately 5.52. We'll remove the electrode from the unknown C solution, rinse, and dry it. What can we conclude from the pH readings of these three unknown solutions? Solutions A and B may be the same solution because they had essentially the same pH. But solution C is definitely a different solution from solutions A and B because of its much higher pH. When we are finished with the pH meter, we will unplug it, reimmerse the pH electrode into its bottle of the storage solution, cap the bottle, and use a piece of parafilm to wrap the top of the bottle to minimize loss of the storage solution due to evaporation or spillage.